fears for our tourism industry this morning, with Queensland expected to join Victoria by banning internationals unless they're triple vaxxed.
For his reaction, let's bring in Queensland's AMA President, Dr. Chris Perry in Brisbane. Good morning to you, Doctor. Thanks for your time this morning. Will locking out double vaxxed overseas visitors make Queensland safer, do you think?
Interesting question, isn't it? Yeah, COVID's all around the place, as you know, Carl. So far, it's fairly mild for people who have been triple vaxxed, not very all that mild for people who've only been double vaxxed, and not mild at all for the elderly and infirmed and disabled children. If you get more people in, you spread it, sure, but it probably the idea of requiring people to have triple vaxxed is to keep the law and the tourism industry nimble, because we're probably going to see other variants come. We haven't, as a human race, haven't taken on the billions of people unvaccinated in the developing world, and the virus mutates in that petri dish of humanity. And if we've got bad ones coming in the future, we'll need the vaccines to be updated. So I think the idea of having updated vaccination requirements is a smart move into the future. It seems unnecessary at the moment, and hopefully in the future it's unnecessary, but I think it's a good move at this stage.
Right, yeah, I mean, I think for a lot of tourism operators, because obviously overseas, I mean, we're pushing in Australia boosters, but you're not seeing a lot of people in the US and the UK who've had their booster shots, have you?
No, they're silly, aren't they? They believe a lot of the stuff they've been spread or talked about by really not very intelligent people. We've only got about 5% of Australians are truly anti-vax. With a bit of encouragement, we'll get to 95, as most jurisdictions have done.
They're not getting the booster, though. They're not getting the booster in the same
levels. No, we're not.
So therefore, is it realistic to expect overseas tourists to have the booster when they come to the country? And if we require that, what's it going to do to our tourism industry?
Yeah, that's the argument. I don't have all the answers on that one, yeah. Carl. I wish I did, but they've got to be nimble. You know, the Omicron COVID may well come back badly. I hope not. I hope we're seeing the dying stages of the whole COVID problem at the moment.
Where do you feel, or how do you feel about where Queensland's sitting at the moment? Because, of course, yesterday Queensland marked its deadliest day.
Yes. Yeah, look, a couple of things about that. There are, you know, a couple of unvaccinated people, and most doctors have given up on the unvaccinated. You know, when they get sick, yeah, we look after them, but there's not much sympathy for the unvaxxed. For the elderly, dying of pneumonia, it's said to be the old person's friend. Something like 19 of the 24 who died were over the age of 80, one at the age of 100. Generally, it's a peaceful death. It's the way most of us are going to die. Most of those upper respiratory infections that bring on the pneumonias occur in winter. Well, COVID, as you know, is a fairly bad upper respiratory infection occurring in summer in Queensland at the moment. So it is killing people at this time of year rather than in the winter.
I don't want you to take offence at this, but I don't want you to ever be my doctor.
I mean, that was
pretty brutal.
That was pretty brutal.
It was pretty brutal. I'm just glad I'm vaxxed.
You got 2 days left, Carl.
Carl, you go up in Brisbane. Did I ever take your tonsils out?
Actually, you might have.
Maybe.
That's what happened.
Thank you, Doctor. Appreciate your time this morning.
When they thought things were finally on the up, yet another potentially crushing blow to the tourism industry, with a ruling expected today on the third jab mandates, which could see millions of overseas visitors cancelling trips to places like the Sunshine State. We're joined now from Cairns by boat trip operator Perry Jones. Perry, good morning to you. You were just on the show literally on Monday, full of hope and excitement over the reopening of our international borders in less than 2 weeks. Take a look at this.
We have been waiting for this time for so long. We can't believe it's actually happening, and we are so excited to actually open up to international travellers again.
Okay, and so you learned the news today about possibly the third mandate. How does that sit with you?
Mate, do I look like I'm smiling? I can't believe it, Carl. I need you to get on the phone today to Palaszczuk, make a call and tell her not to do it, because it will be a death knell. I was so happy a few days ago And I just couldn't believe it when I heard it. Look, I don't disagree on a third booster, but don't make it mandatory. You know, let's not put another death knell. We can't take much more, Carl. We really can't.
I actually think the majority of Australians do absolutely sympathise with you, and a lot would agree with you on that. I mean, the reason why you're so upset is it's pretty easy to see when you look at the stats. These are the booster rates of the countries, the top list who visit Australia. The UK only has 55% triple vaxxed. The USA just 27% triple vaxxed. And for China, it's just a third who are triple vaxxed, all those tourists. What is it going to do to your business?
Mate, I'm nearly in tears. Honestly, we've just took 2 years, and for this to happen just as we think we're going to get back on our feet, I just don't know, mate. Have you got a job? I need a job. You got a job as a reporter or a wiggle? I'll take anything at the moment.
Look, you know, Perry, I fully, my heart bleeds for you because I know how hard you all work up there. It's not just Queensland. I mean, think about tourism locations in Victoria, New South Wales, Western Australia. They're all going to be in the same boat here. People say on the street, as we've just heard in our news, talking to Jess Millwood, our reporter, you know, one of the priorities has got to be keeping people safe. Do you get that?
Carl, we've been hearing this for 2 years, keeping people safe. We've been hearing this for 2 years, the hospitals are going to be overrun. We heard this year we're going to have the worst cyclone season we've ever had. People make these predictions and they don't happen. You know, most of us are double vaxxed. We've all done the right thing.
Agree.
Let us, you know, help us now. You know, I mean, we have suffered so much, and our crews have suffered so much. They've got to let us open the borders.
I agree, and at some point, that third vaccine, and look, there might be four, five, six, seven, who knows how many more. At some point, that's going to come down to not legislation, but just personal responsibility. How many more are they going to have to legislate? I mean, how many more are overseas going to take? You see the numbers dropping off already. So how much more does business need to suffer before they make it about personal responsibility rather than legislation?
Mate, perfectly said. Absolutely. I got tingles there, mate. You've just hit it on the nail there, Carl, is we've got to start living with it. Let's be adults now. Understand that we've got to live with this like we live with the flu and live with the cold and stuff like that. Look, two boosters, we've all done the right thing. Let's move on. I'm not against free, but don't mandate it. You know, Carl, I want you to phone Palaszczuk today and plead our case, please. We need the borders open now.
Well, it's not just her, it's the other premiers. And I think, again, I'm incredibly worried about our tourism industry right now. This is not going to be great for them in any way, shape or form. Perry, stay strong. Let's hope something good happens to you in the next couple of days, but I'm not sure what it is. Appreciate your time.
Carl, I want you and Ali out on the boat when you come up here, all right?
All right, my man. Thank you. Stay strong. Ali.